On macOS, in addition to Postgres, we are also going to install a tool called pgAdmin. pgAdmin is a very popular tool that's used to somehow manage or otherwise interact with your running Postgres server. So we're going to download and install pgAdmin from pgadmin.org/download. I'll copy that link right away. Open it up inside of a browser tab. And then once here, you can find macOS. Go ahead and download the macOS version. You'll find the DMG file right here. Go ahead and click it. And that'll start up the download. And once again, just to save a little bit of time, I went ahead and downloaded this right before this video. So once it's all done downloading, you're going to find a DMG file. We're going to again open that thing up. Hit agree. And then it'll do a little bit of setup for us. After the setup, come on. There we go. We'll find pgAdmin listed right there. Now, we do still have to do this drag and drop operation into our applications directory, just like we did with Postgres. But in this case, there's not actually any folder in here that we can nicely drag and drop to. So you need to open up a second Finder window. Make sure you can see that applications folder, hopefully inside of your favorites. And we're going to do a drag and drop over to applications. Once you do that, you're going to eventually see that progress bar pop up very similarly to this. And after a little bit, it's going to eventually copy over entirely to that applications folder. Now it looks like this is going to take a little bit, so I'll pause the video right here. Once that transfer is all complete, I'm going to open up that applications folder and then find pgAdmin4 and double-click it. The first time you run it, you might be prompted with a little security warning. Just go ahead and make sure you hit open. You'll then see a little window like that, a little startup window, and then eventually a new tab will open automatically inside of your browser, just like this right here. Now, if your application doesn't automatically open up inside your browser, you're going to go up to your status bar, find a little icon up here that looks like a little elephant face, and then click on New pgAdmin 4 Window. This little button right here is how we're going to open up pgAdmin 4 in general after you have closed it. The first time you open up pgAdmin 4, you're going to be prompted to set up a password. This is a password just to access pgAdmin on your local machine. It is solely a security thing to make sure that if anyone else gets access to your laptop, they cannot just open up pgAdmin 4 and start changing data inside of a database. So you can use any password here you want to use. Me personally, I'm just going to enter in password. Honestly, if anyone gets access to my laptop, I got some bigger issues, and my laptop is already password protected and the hard drive is encrypted. So personally, not a big deal for me. All right, so once we've got that all put together, we're going to add our new server or the database that we just launched using that Postgres app. Once we do so, we'll then be able to view the data inside the database and also change some settings to it as well. So to add that local database that we just created with the PG or the Postgres app, we're going to go to the left-hand side, right-click on servers, go to create, and then server. I'll then enter in a name of localhost. I'm going to go to connection. Under host, I will enter in localhost. And then finally, for username right here, we're going to change Postgres to whatever your system username is. So remember, whenever you log on to your macOS system, you log on as a certain user. You're going to put your username right there. If you don't remember what it is, you can always open up your terminal and run who am I, all one word. That will then print out your system username. So for me, it is SG, short for my name, Stephen Greider. So I'll put in SG right there. You are not going to be putting in SG. You'll be putting in whatever your system username is. I'll then click on save, and that should be it. We should then see localhost appear on the left-hand side. I can then expand databases, and inside of here, you should see two different databases, one called Postgres, and another one that is named after your username once again. So I see SG right here. You're going to see a different one named after your username. All right, so that's it. We've got pgAdmin set up and Postgres set up as well. Now at this point, you might be saying, hey, what is pgAdmin all about? What are we using it for? Well, we're going to do a deep dive on pgAdmin because it is a critical part of understanding what Postgres is all about. We're going to do a deep dive on this in due time. So now that we've got everything set up, let's take a pause right here and continue in just a moment.